Developing overnight, sources tell CNN the January 6th committee is interested in speaking to members of Mike Pence's inner circle. Among them is Pence's former national security advisor, Keith Kellogg, who was with former President Trump most of the day of the insurrection. Joining me now, CNN political analyst Carl Bernstein. Carl, this is Jamie Gangel and others reporting from yesterday. You think this is potentially significant. Why?
It's very significant. First of all, let's look at what's happening here. We are talking about a conspiracy like no other in the history of the United States to undermine an election led this conspiracy by the President of the United States. And there are some people who worked for Mike Pence who indeed are angry about the conspiracy and that Pence was brought into it indirectly. Finally, Pence did the right thing. He certified the election, presided over the election of the duly elected President of the United States, Joseph Biden. But we have a year to go here to find out what happened. Until the Republicans, in all likelihood, take over the Congress, they're going to try to shut down this investigation. The press, particularly the committee, 1 year to go to find out what happened in the most grievous assault on democracy since the Confederacy in the Civil War.
You say there are people inside Pence's inner circle who are angry.
Yes.
Why is that important?
Because there are people who believe in the Constitution of the United States. Even in the Republican Party, there are people who still believe in the Constitution, despite the fact that the party has been taken over by craven Republicans and made the party of Trumpism and authoritarianism. But there are some people there, and it is the job of the press, the job of this committee, but particularly the press, to find a witness or several witnesses, perhaps among Pence's aides, not necessarily his principals, as Jamie Gandel has reported, but maybe there are some aides to the aides. We're interested in the information. We've got a year to get it to unravel this horrible conspiracy.
Someone who, if that person exists, and if that person saw something, who would call it out publicly. You compare this to a John Dean
That's
character.
Right.
Whom you dealt with, obviously, when you were reporting on Watergate.
Well, if you go look at Bob Woodward's and my papers down at the University of Texas, what happened in Watergate is we got to John Dean before he testified, and we knew that he was going to name the President of the United States as the head of the conspiracy in Watergate, and that he was going to turn on the President of the United States. Our job in the press right now, above all others, is to unravel this conspiracy before the Republican Party, captured by Donald Trump, is able to suppress what happened here. It is the business of the nation. And this committee might have a shot. I keep coming back to this idea of, you know, in Watergate, we got a list of everybody who worked for the President of the United States in his reelection. The committee is trying to do the same thing and find a couple of these people, and there are indications from Republicans I talked to, it's not just the Republicans on the committee, but there are other Republicans in the House, in the Senate particularly, who despise Trump, who believe that this conspiracy can be unraveled if other Republicans talking to each other, which is happening now to some extent, keep pursuing this. Mm-hmm. It doesn't have to get out necessarily under oath. It could happen in pre-interviews, for instance, with some of the people who were named in Jamie Gandel.
You talk about Republicans getting going. I don't know if there are Republicans necessarily who want to go back and look at the insurrection more, find out the truth
there. Well, that's the problem.
But it does seem, based on Chris Christie's comments this morning, I don't have time to play them again now, but he sort of punched President Trump, the former president, right in the nose a little bit.
Well, also, Christie is looking to be president of the United States himself, and he's got, you talk about threading the needle.
So, but if you think that's the way to become president, it says that there is at least one Republican, and you say there are Republicans who are growing frustrated with the former president, too. Maybe there are some beginning to turn after Virginia?
No. They're still embracing Trumpism. They're terrified of Donald Trump, but there might be a few. But let's look again. This Republican Party, like the Democratic Party in the Confederacy, particularly the Southern Democrats in the Confederacy, have been captured by the Trumpist movement. They have been captured by an authoritarian movement, unlike anything we've seen since the secessionist Democrats, led by Jefferson Davis in the Civil War, who have sought to undermine the unity and the absolute basis of our democracy. And let me go back to the press again. This is our job for the next year above all else. If we get this narrative, and I say this to all my colleagues out there, this is the story that we cannot lose focus on, and we'll get it if we pursue it.
Carl Bernstein, thank you for being with us.
Good to be with you.